All right, with 2 minutes remaining in halftime. It's the Manitoba Bisons up 37-33. We do apologize for the audio issues in the first half. I think last night we had some issues in the first half as well. Had some turnover with our technical crew here in the lightning rod. However, getting these bugs worked out, and we'll be delivering the remainder of the women's game with full audio. Once again, 37-33, Manitoba Bisons lead. Katie Ulakovic with 6 points for the Wolves, while the Bisons their leading scorer, I believe, is Robin Iyer with 11 points. The Bisons, of course, making a run at the end of that first half. After Lakehead had led for most of that first half, Bisons making a run, a couple of three-pointers from Iyer, and slowing down the Lakehead offense. It'll be Manitoba ball here to begin here in the second half. Show and go from number 8 on the Bisons. Morgan Cross, her shot's no good. Ulakovic will come back the other way. Close to a travel there. Entry pass, a dangerous one to Jacobson. She's fouled by Cross. Go to the line, shoot two. First free throw rims out for Jacobson. As does the second. Those free throws likely going to prove critical down the stretch here. However, lots of time left. Drive and kick. The baseline shot from Sam Pike. Doesn't go down. Kalkin now working back the other way. Bardsley. Over to DeHaan. Jacobson. Bardsley with a pull-up. But a shot clock violation as she did not hit the rim. Be Manitoba basketball. Samantha Pike, baseline shot once again not falling. Kalkin the rebound. Ice it with the skip pass to Yelakovic. Very deep three. Off the mark. It's knocked loose on the ground. It'll be a jump ball. I think it's going to be Lakehead ball. As the Bisons did get it to begin this half. DeHaan. Up top to Aisha. Jacobson working it inside. Got position. Finished it off. I believe she is now Lakehead's leading scorer with 8 points. As Lakehead trails by two, 37-35. Bardsley for three. No good. Baseline to Bardsley. Shot fake and go. Nice dish to Jacobson. Can't get that one to go. Nice sequence, just not the finishing touch. Jacobson knocks it loose. Bardsley to DeHaan. Lakehead with some quick offense the last couple times down. Carmona Galdemez working again. She's trapped by Bardsley and Aisha, but they swing the ball out. Get it loose. That shot's no good from Belasco. Kalkin throws up a right-hand scoop. Foul is going to be called on the rebound. Basket's no good. Couple of subs coming in for the Bisons. Full shift change, actually. And Inkela will come in for DeHaan. Five new Bisons on the court. Ilakovic comes off the screen, gets Aisha freed up. Looking for Jacobson inside. Left hand. No good. -35 Manitoba leads. Not a whole lot of offense for either squad so far. This could be getting coming close. 2 and 8 second call. It certainly was close. However, Manitoba with a rushed offense.
Jump ball is the call. Lincoln University retains possession. Check it back in for the Thunderwolves. It's number 8, Kylie Kuchta. The substitution is brought to you by Subway.
Kylie Kuchta into the game for Kelsey Bardsley. Screening action. Up high for Kalkin. It's knocked loose. A little shovel pass from Kalkin to Jacobson. For a shiny dime, it's tied at 37. That shot off the mark. Bisons get the offensive board. Here's Montan. And that shot blocked by Aisha. Still alive in the paint. It's up, not in. Jacobson pulls down the rebound. Here's Jelakovic. Streaking it down the lane. And she'll go to the free throw line to shoot two.
Bisons foul committed by number 15, Vanessa DeVries. That is her second personal foul and third team foul. Here to the game for Lincoln University is number 22, Ashley Randall. Two free throws for the Thunderwolves. Number 9, Katie Ulakovic.
So a couple of free throws go down for Jelakovic. It's 39-37. Manitoba ball. We'll resume audio commentary in just one moment. All right, so we're tied up at 39, Manitoba. Here's Judd with the left-hand drive. That drive doesn't go down. Vanessa DeVries right there on the doorstep with the stick back. And Sulius. Was fouled by Chrissy Fisher. And the Bisons are in the penalty. 41-39, Bisons lead. Cassandra Sulius at the line. The Lakehead women, I feel. I've got a feeling, folks. Could be right down the wire. Neither team really able to create any distance. or rhythm in their offenses. Sulius hitting both, so we're tied at 41. Oh, wow. Aisha Calkin stripping that ball away after Sherry Kimona Galdamez had beaten her down the floor. Kicks it. Kuchta. Pull up off glass. No good. Bisons control. DeVries. Up the right side now. Steph Gill. Carmona Galdamez. Montan. DeVries, Montan. Posthumous. Carmona Galdamez got that one off just barely. Oh, wow. And Aisha Calkin getting up slowly. May have rolled her ankle on that play, but she is so tough. Oh, wow. Bad pass there from Sulius. Hands it right back to the Bisons. And this is what I was talking about. Neither team really flowing very well. That shot a two-pointer from Stephanie Gill. Lob pass to Jacobson. Help is there. Going to get a foul call on Sherry Carmona Galdamez, who disagrees with the referee. And that's her fourth personal. So, cheap or not, that foul may complicate things for the Bisons here. Of course, Robin Iyer coming back into the game, who's had a great shooting night. She's got 11 points, all of them in the first half, I believe. It's Jacobson hits the first free throw, and the second's also good, tying it up at 43 points apiece. Inside, out to DeVries. Montan, driving kick. Around the horn now. Here's Gill. Step back three. Ooh, just missed. Aisha Calkin in the open court. She's going to take it all the way. Just rims out. Jacobson there with the stick back. Gives Lakehead the lead once again. Their first lead since earlier in the second quarter. That shot from Steph Gill. Tie things up at 45. Calkin at the top. Clock winding down. Jacobson finishes it nicely to finish the third quarter. Give Jacobson 16 points now on the evening. As Lakehead takes the lead, 47-45. I believe it was last night we had the score 44-40 favoring the Thunderwolves heading into the third quarter. Similar type of pace this evening between the Bisons and Thunderwolves. Now last night I thought the magic number was 60. First team to 60 would win. This evening, I'm not so sure. You could probably add a few points to that one. course, Heckler's Row more of a factor this evening. Manitoba perhaps not getting as much out of their timeouts. But then again, great players rise to the occasion, and great players, and I think, would really enjoy this environment, challenging as it may be. Challenging as it may be to get clear communication there in the huddle. So on the court now for the Bisons, Belasco, Steph Gill, Robin Iyer, Morgan Cross, as well as Christian Fisher. For the Wolves, it's Ulakevic, Jacobson, Andrea Zen, and Bardsley. That drive broken up. Now here's Robin Iyer for three, and it is good. Gives the Bisons the lead, 48-47. Jacobson working inside. Kicks it to Zen. Lakehead's offense really going through Jacobson. This time, Ulakovic with a little hesitation off of that screen from Jacobson. Gives Lakehead the lead, 49-48. Stephanie Gill at the top getting a screen from Belasco. Now it's Iyer. Ooh. Foul call on Caitlin Zen. So Kylie Kuchta will come into the game for Kelsey Bardsley. Now it's Cross. Hands it back to Gill. To Cross. On the left side. Lost the handle. Looking for help. Shot clock winding down. Going to be a long bomb. No touch. So that's a shot clock violation. And Lakehead will control. Kuchta comes off a screen. Ooh, Jacobson may have been open off of that roll. Now she's got it on the block with the move. Drop step with the left hand. Gets that one to go. And a three-point lead for Lakehead. Cross takes Jacobson off the bounce now to the left. Gets that one to go. Ulakovic. Hands it off to Kuchta. Same play as last time. Looking down low. Zen feeds Jacobson. Skip pass out to Kuchta for three. That's blocked. Jacobson gets the ball. Shot clock running down. Zen's going to have to put it up. Just off the rim. Caitlin Andrea, though, with an offensive board. Thumbs down play. Kuchta gets all the way to the rim, finishes. Three-point lead for Lakehead, 53-50. Belasco around the horn now to Morgan Cross. Up top for Iyer, finds Belasco in the paint. She's hacked, and it'll go to the line to shoot two.
Second foul. Back in the game for Lincoln University, number 11, Aisha Kempkin, number 7,
So Caitlin Zen comes out of the game. Kelsey Bardsley is back in. That shot off the rim. Belasco rattles the second one around and down. It's a two-point game. Lakehead leading 53-51. High screen action. Bardsley finds Jacobson with room in the paint. Can't get it to go. Calkin crashing on the offensive board. Knocked that one out of bounds. Bisons basketball. We've got 6.5 minutes to play here in the game. 53-51. Lakehead leads. Belasco. Running shot there through the lane. Didn't go. Dangerous outlet pass is just controlled by Bardsley. Now Calkin. Awkward angle on the attempt. Couldn't get it off the glass. A three-pointer now. In transition is no good. Let's see what Bardsley can do. Finding Andrea on the run with a nice touch off the rim. Lakehead certainly is able to use any fast break points they can get. Stephanie Gill driving left. Kicks it back to Morgan Cross. Showed and then flipped it up in the middle. And that one's going to go down for Morgan Cross. Nice right hand flip. So Lakehead Biggs going to get a breath, I would guess. I'm going to go right back in. Jessica DeHaan has to hustle to get this one. But it will be Lakehead ball. No one getting to that rebound. Here's Jerrica Baldwin. Hands it off to Calkin. Aisha crosses over, gets into the lane. Ooh, she got hit from behind by Samantha Pike. So Lakehead with a two-point lead. 5.5 to go here in the game. First is good. 56-53. Aisha knew it was off when she let it go. Got her own rebound. What is it going to be? A rebounding foul on Samantha Pike. Bit of a lucky break there for the Bisons as Andrea did finish the play. Jerrica Baldwin gets the ball off the inbounds, throws it up. Loose ball, Aisha Calkin controls, hands it off to DeHaan. She finishes the play. Inside now to Pike. Working against McNaughton. And Aisha Calkin with a hard crash. She can't believe it. And as I mentioned, for most of the weekend, the referees have been calling games pretty tight. Any physical contact getting a pretty quick whistle. Mon Anton coming off a screen, can't get open, but it's underneath. Tipped away by Dahan on the baseline. See what the Bisons can do. Got a hand on it on the inbounds, but it's into the hands of DeVries, and she will finish it off. Tough break for the Thunderwolves there. Oh, my. And Samantha Pike laid out Jessica Dahan as she knew that she was beat. So a couple of subs coming in. Kylie Kuchta and Essa Jacobson for the Wolves. And for the Bisons, Christina Postumus. Dahan gets it blocked, goes right back up. Can't get it to go. Jacobson giving her some help on the glass. And Dahan looks like she rolled her ankle. And not a good sign right now. That right leg looks like it is in some pain. Lindsay Inkela is going to come in. Lakehead still clutching to a three-point lead. It's 58-55. Game getting a little chippy now. Going down the stretch. Players' legs, no doubt tired. Lakehead, this is their third game in as many nights. Montan with the three. Ties it up at 58. 4 minutes playing. Kuchta crosses over. Gets it inside to Jacobson. She can't finish it off. She's been great in the post all night. Here's DeVries up at the top. Montan finds DeVries, but not quite. Pass was a little offline. So both teams giving the other plenty of chances. We're tied at 58. Falcon in the lane. Out to Inkela for three. And she was fouled by Christina Postumus. So the Bisons will call a timeout. Both teams will be in the penalty from here on out. 3:19 to play. So Lindsay Inkela will have three free throws when we get back into the action here. Free throws. Definitely going to be playing a factor. Inkela with three coming up. First is good. Second one, not so much. Hitting front rim. Third also missing, so just one of three there. 59-58. Here's Gill. Looking for some help. Morgan Cross. Ooh, wow. She was looking for Allison Belasco in the lane. Belasco had some nice position there in the center of the lane and was fouled on the catch by Asa Jacobson. That's her fourth personal. Belasco misses the first. So both teams as stated before, giving the other an opportunity. Belasco misses the second. Ball squirts up to the top and now into the hands of Aisha Culkin on the left side, who just controls it, goes into heavy traffic, kicks it to Yulakovic. Ooh, tough entry pass there. Back to Inkela, Yulakovic, Aisha Culkin, fakes right, goes left down the lane, off glass, and through. Stephanie Gill. Belasco, great position in there. Bison player elected to take it on her own. Lakehead has a chance to make this a two-possession game. Kuchta over to Aisha Culkin. Jacobson in the high post. Lindsay Inkela from distance. Swish. And Manitoba will call a timeout. Lindsay Inkela with a smile on her face. Making up for those missed free throws with a three-pointer that drops. Just under 2 minutes to play. 64-58. So the Thunderwolves with a six-point cushion now, which I think could be their largest lead of the game, actually. Once again, 1:57 to play. And we're going to see Ashley Randall into the game now, I believe for the first time. Trying to protect Asa Jacobson on this defensive stand. And Randall came to help. And fouled the shooter. So Sherry Carmona Galdamez that free throw off the mark. So the Bisons missing the last three free throws. Galdamez hitting that one as Lakehead now will call a timeout. course, teams at this stage in the game not leaving much to chance in terms of putting their team up against a full court pressure situation after a score, instead electing to call a timeout, advance the ball. Of course, Lakehead, that was only their first timeout called this half, so they do have two remaining. With a 5-point lead, minute 50 left. Bisons did a good job of getting a quick shot there last time down the floor. So Lakehead on the sideline into Ulakovic. She's quickly doubled. Lots of pressure there. Lakehead going to have to move the ball. Here's Inkela with a free lane. Puts it up. No good. Carmona Galdamez, left-hand drive. She's fouled by Kylie Kuchta. Last time down the floor, Lindsay Inkela not able to convert, although she definitely had the lane on that drive. Carmona Galdamez hits the first. Lakehead needing a strong box out here. So the second goes through.
Timeout, Lakehead University.
And Lakehead will call another timeout. So that last time, Manitoba's strategy on the inbounds just to swarm the ball handler. And Lakehead able to get a decent shot. May have been some contact, maybe not. In either case, Manitoba has gone on a 3-0 run in the last 24 seconds. Lakehead needing to stay aggressive here. And, of course, take care of the basketball. Once again, she swarmed. Ulakovic back to Bardsley. Bardsley into Jacobson. Quick shot. She's in trouble. Puts it up. And she called with the travel. So, 3-point game after that Lakehead turnover. Stephanie Gill, pull-up shot, no good. Ulakovic had it knocked out of her hands by DeVries. It'll be Lakehead ball. 61 seconds to play. Here's Calkin. Turns the corner. Calls out the play. Oh, my. Another turnover from Calkin. Bad pass on the drive. Galdamez kicks it out. 3-pointer from Iyer. No good. Rebound, Calkin. into the hands of Vilakovic. 35 seconds to play. Lakehead with a three-point lead. Bardsley. Randall, jumper. Off rim, no good. 15 seconds to play. Stephanie Gill, Manitoba needing a three. It's Iyer, no good. Culkin will get the rebound. Knocked down, loose ball on the floor. Inkela ties it up. 2.8 seconds left on the clock. And the Wolves, by virtue of the possession arrow, will retain possession. Very lucky break there. Lakehead really not scoring at all in the last 2 minutes or more. And Manitoba shooters with a couple of good looks at threes was Robin Iyer, I believe, with a good look, couple of good looks the last couple times down. So 2.8 seconds left. Lakehead's ball to inbound on the sideline. Manitoba will no doubt foul quickly. So 1.3 seconds rolls off the clock. Blair McNaughton will go to the free throw line, needing only to hit one to put this game on ice. And she does. So 65-61. Make it 66. So the Bisons will go through the motions, of course, make every effort to make it close. Of course, safe to say this game is in the books at this point. Lakehead with a five-point lead, 1.5 seconds on the clock. No foreseeable way, even if Manitoba did hit a three, I don't think there would be time to get a foul and another possession. Here we go. Inbound. Shots up. And it's short. 66-61. The Lakehead Thunderwolves women's basketball team starts the season 3-0 this weekend with wins over Algoma, Laurentian, and now the Manitoba Bisons. So next up here from the Thunderdome will be our Saturday evening finale, the Lakehead men taking on the Brandon Bobcats. Should be a good one, folks. So all those in Lakehead, Thunderbolt Nation, I should say, you can switch over channels here on ssncanada.ca, and we will resume broadcast in about 19 minutes from now with myself and Zach White Lightning here in the booth. Don't go anywhere.